Hi everyone, it's Quickie Baby and welcome back to Water Tanks, and today we have the pleasure of watching De Rirola Barnes from the European server playing in the Panzer KW1. This is not a Soviet vehicle, and in today's video, De Rirola Barnes is going to make it look like they're practically cheating in World of Tanks. This vehicle was available, I believe, in the loot boxes from last year's Christmas event. Although you don't really see too many of them out on the battlefield. And in today's video, I'm going to question why. Because you're going to see that De Rirola Barnes is going to make this thing look like it's absolutely ridiculous. So, this is effectively the Panzerkampfwagen KW1. It's kind of like a captured KV-1 with a different kind of turret. Now, this vehicle has quite a few things that are better than the KV-1 and also quite a few things that are worse than the KV-1. One of the things that I'd like to highlight first is that the vehicle actually has quite a substantial amount of spaced armor over the front on this plate you can see here. And so that makes one of the weakest plates of the KV-1, that mid plate, if you are hiding your lower plate, substantially better. So that's a big advantage of this vehicle. Next, it actually has 10 degrees of gun depression, which is absolutely wonderful for when you're working a ridgeliner. Not many Soviet vehicles are able to get reasonable amounts of gun depression. I believe the KV-1 with its 7 degrees actually has amongst the better gun depression that you'll have on most of your Soviet tanks until you get towards the double barrel tanks. Or, as we saw in my video from last week, the Object 752, that new Tier 9 premium Soviet heavy, right? So that is really the two things that are better about this vehicle. However, there are quite a few things that are worse. Firstly, the damage per minute on this vehicle is 1,700, and while that's definitely not bad for Tier 5, it's also not great for Tier 5. And the KV-1 has a choice of guns. You could either use the 57mm and get 2,200 damage per minute, or you could use the 85mm and hit substantially harder than this vehicle for 160. This 75mm, which is the only gun you can use on the vehicle as its premium, has 162mm of pen on its gold rounds with 110 alpha, and it has 115mm of pen for its 110 alpha on its standard rounds. So really, this is going to be a case of, it's not the fact that this is an overpowered tank, it's probably going to be the case that Barnes is an absolute ridiculous tanker, and they're going to show you exactly why. So whenever you play a low tier tank, you always want to see Wide Park, especially if you're playing Tier 6, as this is a map which used to be available for Tier 10, but is now only available for Tier 6 and below. So whenever I'm signing up in a Tier 6 tank, it is the dream to be able to get this, because you know you are going to be top tier. Now, Barnes is going to go to town on this OI Experimental. I would say the OI Experimental used to be the most overpowered tank tier for tier in the game at one point before Wargaming nerfed it massively, and quite right for them to nerf it massively too, as that was the kind of tank that when I went onto the What Replays website, even if I saw that it got 14 kills, I wouldn't even watch the game, because it was just another 14 kill game in a tank which plays out itself. However, the tables have turned now, and the OI, even though it's using the derp gun with 360 alpha damage, is not able to penetrate the front of the Panzer KW1. And now, the B1, another little OP Tier 4 German heavy tank. Oh, actually, sorry, no, that's the French version of it. That's not the Panzer B2740. Finds out that they can't go through the front of the KW-1 either. The Lux has tried to get behind Barnes. Barnes' opponents are literally throwing themselves at him, and they're still unable to be able to break through the front of this tank. Barnes is just angling this vehicle perfectly, and it's like they've used some kind of mind control device on the enemy team. They are practically cheating in this game, with the opponents just unable to challenge the front of the vehicle. Well, at least caster's curse there, right? As the KV-1 manages to go through for the second time. So it looks like the KV-1 kind of knows what they're doing. With 85 alpha damage on that vehicle, it looks like that KV-1 is using the 57mm, which has good pen. However, doesn't look like they have a fire extinguisher, as Barnes lights them up, and within the first 4 minutes of this game has managed to pick up 3,500 damage and secure 6 frags. That is all but one of the kills secured by their team so far, meaning that Barnes has a lot of work left to do, as there are still 8 tanks left on the enemy team. Although, looks like it's going to be one less now, as Barnes finishes off the pesky T-82 HMC. However, their base is vulnerable. But this is one of the best things about the Panzer KW-1, as I said, was that 10 degrees of gun depression means that you've got more than enough to be flexible. Oh gosh, the M8A1 flanks Barnes. Barnes auto-aims, delivers the first shell. Will they high-roll the second shell? Yes, they do, meaning they save themselves some hit points. Auto-aims at the BT-7 as well, and they donate another hit point to mean that Barnes is now up to 9 frags this game. Barnes fires one at the Cruiser 7, fully aims the shot, and a good thing too, because that Cruiser 4, not a Cruiser 7, sorry, was loading gold and butchering the front of the KW-1. Almost as if what most of the other teammates on Barnes' team should have done against the front of the vehicle, although that B-1, that Tier 4 tanktree tank, was trying to do it. Okay, so now, with the KV-1 SA on Barnes' team falling, they now find themselves in a 1-versus-4 scenario. They have 451 hit points left against the 1,400 hit points of the enemy team. There are 2 tier 5s and 2 tier 4s to deal with, and the enemy team, seeing that Barnes has managed to secure 10 kills single-handedly, would be bold if they were to go and try and go after them. So the Leopard takes one shell. The Leopard fails to pen any gold rounds on the front of this vehicle with poor aim and good angling by Barnes. And suddenly this Leopard, who looks like they have their turret jammed here, now is in a very awkward scenario as Barnes carves up one of the tier 5 light tanks on the enemy team. However, all 3 of the enemy are now in the cap circle, and with 9 seconds left, 8 seconds left, Barnes finally gets an interrupt on the KV-1 SA. But there's still 2 tanks capping. So Barnes, you're gonna have to reset one of the other vehicles. You've only got 7 seconds left. 6, 5, 4, 3, and a miss. 2, 1. Oh, Barnes gets the reset on the Stuk 3B. Who are they gonna focus at? This is a very precarious situation where there's just so many tanks with so many hit points, and Barnes has to try and find the KV-1 SA here. Manages to set them on fire, shoots the looks, destroying 2 vehicles at the same time with that fire. Now up to 13 kills. They're going to be trying to contest for the Rezane Heroes Medal here. And it was almost a formality. Oh my goodness gracious. In less than 7 minutes, Barnes managed to destroy 14 out of 15 players on the enemy team, getting more kills than I've ever got in World of Tanks. And they made it look so easy. Barnes, you're practically cheating in this game. Although I think a lot of it was down to the fact of this extra spaced armor over the mid plate. But do keep in mind that there's no spaced armor, I believe, for this plate here. And there's also none behind the machine gun as well, if you do manage to see this vehicle. But Barnes showing you that the German KV-1 just does it better. So this was an absolute monster game for a monster player. Barnes, congratulations to you on getting the one that nobody gets, the Rezane Heroes Medal, for destroying 14 tanks, a cool header for surviving 10 ricochets in a row, the mother of all defender medals for protecting the cap circle, and a Nadens medal for destroying all of the enemy light tanks on the enemy team. That is a very hard thing to do at low tier because there's so many light tanks. As well as a high caliber medal for 5,300 damage dealt in a tier 5 vehicle. Over 6 times what anyone else on their team was able to achieve, and a steel wall medal for ricocheting 4,300 damage, enough to kill this vehicle 5 times over. And while Barnes spent a lot on ammunition, they still make 92,000 credits profit, albeit with an 80k payout for a mission, so it was still a cool 12k profit. To get that, as well as the Rezane Heroes medal that, again, hardly anyone gets in the game, boy, this was a monster round of World of Tanks. And it's an absolute tragedy that Barnes wasn't able to put the final shot into the B1 and secure 15 kills. Otherwise, they would have got the only 15 kill game throughout the entirety of 2023 that was uploaded onto the What Replays website. Nevertheless, with 2,748 base experience, it's no wonder that Barnes says, really sweated at the end while 3 enemies were capping. Look, this is the definition of hyper carry in World of Tanks. Congratulations to you, Barnes, for this monster game. Thank you so much for uploading it onto the What Replays website. And thank you so much for honoring me by putting Quickie Baby in the title to let me know that you want to be featured on the channel. And if any of you have absolutely epic monster games that you think are suitable for the channel, then upload them onto the What Replays website and put QB on the title or Quickie Baby. And while I can't promise that I'm going to watch all of them, it's your best chance of getting through. Anyway, ladies and gents, boys and girls, that was practically cheating in World of Tanks. Really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you hated it, give it a thumbs down. And let me know in the comments down below, what tank do you think is best at getting a huge kill game. And as always, thank you so much for watching. You've been epic, and hopefully I'll see you soon.